बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। इन टुडेज़ लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द सैम्पलिंग ऑफ कंटिन्यूस टाइम सिग्नल्स। बेसिकली वी आर स्टडीइंग दिस चैप्टर फ्रॉम ओपन हेम बुक चैप्टर 4। नॉर्मली डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल्स कैन राइज इन मेनी वेज, बट द मोस्ट कॉमनली अकर एज रिप्रेजेंटेशंस ऑफ सैम्पल कंटिन्यूस टाइम सिग्नल्स। We have a lot of sources that generate discrete time signals, but in nature most of the sources generate continuous time signals, and in order to process them through a digital processor, we have to convert that continuous time signal into a digital signal in order to process that signal through a digital processor. So first of all, we have to convert that continuous time signal into discrete time signal. So we can obtain a discrete time signal from a continuous time signal according to this relation, that x of n, which is a discrete time signal, it can be obtained from a continuous time signal through sampling. Here t is the sampling period, and its reciprocal is f of s. It is the sampling frequency. We can have, this is a system that basically perform the sampling process continuous to discrete time. The input is a continuous time signal x sub ct, and here we decide about the sampling frequency the sampling time period, and here we get the output, that is a discrete time signal x sub n. So we refer to this system, actually this system implements the operation in this equation, and it is an ideal continuous to a discrete time converter. But in practical setting, the operation of sampling is implemented by an analog to digital converter. But in practical, sampling can be performed by an analog to digital converter, and such system can be viewed as approximation to the ideal continuous to discrete time converter. But in analog to digital converter, we have some important concentrations in the implementation of the analog to digital converter, in which we have some quantization of output samples, and we have some limitations over the sampling rate. So it is convenient to represent the sampling process mathematically in two stages. So here actually this is the continuous time signal x sub ct. It is multiplied with a impulse train s sub t, and here is the output, this is x sub st, and here this is conversion from impulse train into discrete time signal, and finally this is the x sub n, which comes from the continuous time signal through periodic sampling. Now, we have a little bit to think about this process. This is actually a continuous time signal. This signal is multiplied with an impulse train, and this is the output of the impulse train. Okay? So, we know that S of t, it is an impulse train, and it is from minus infinity to infinity. This is S of t, and this can be represented graphically as one, two, three and so on, -1, -2 and so on. So this is S of t. What we have to do, we have to multiply this signal with X of t, X of ct. This is a continuous time signal. So let's suppose this is a continuous time signal, and it is the time t is equal to 0 up to some t is equal to 10, and this is, let's suppose, -10. So this is a continuous time signal, X of ct. Now we have to convert this continuous time signal into a discrete time signal. So simply we have to multiply these two signals in order to get the samples of this continuous time signal. So this process can be performed by multiplication. So now actually what we have done, we have multiplied this continuous time signal with an impulse train. This is a continuous time signal. We have just multiplied this signal with an impulse train, and the result is this discrete time signal. So this is actually the continuous time signals, and we have taken samples of this continuous time signal to get the discrete time signal. So we know that multiplication, now if we are going to see all this process in the frequency domain, then we have to convert from time domain into frequency domain. We have to go from time domain into frequency domain. We have to convert this X of ct from time domain into frequency domain. We have to convert this time domain into frequency domain, and we have to convert this process of multiplication into frequency domain. And we know that multiplication in time domain corresponds to convolution in the frequency domain, and convolution in time domain is multiplication in frequency domain. So if we are want to study this process in the frequency domain, then we have to convert this signal into frequency domain, this into frequency domain, and this, the process of the multiplication becomes convolution in the frequency domain, and then we have to see the result, this result in the frequency domain. But before going into the frequency domain, I want to give you a recall about convolution. अब आप लोग यहाँ पे देखें, बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आइडियल सैम्पलिंग, लेट रिकॉल सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट. नंबर फर्स्ट, वी नो दैट कन्वोल्यूशन इन टाइम डोमेन इज मल्टीप्लिकेशन इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन, एंड मल्टीप्लिकेशन इन टाइम डोमेन इज कन्वोल्यूशन इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन. द सेकंड मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट इज कन्वोल्यूशन ऑफ एनी सिग्नल विद द यूनिट इम्पल्स विल रिजल्ट द सेम सिग्नल. Mean when X of n is convolved with the unit impulse, it will give you the same signal X of n, and If this signal XRP in is convolved with the delayed version of the unit impulse function, then it will basically delay the same signal by the same amount of delay. So if XRP in is convolved with delayed unit impulse, so it will simply delay the original signal XRP in. So XRP in convolved with sigma n minus 1, it will result into XRP in minus 1. Actually, it will result the original signal by the same delay. Also, if XRP in is convolved with the unit impulse plus a delayed version of the unit impulse, so the result will be XRP in convolved with sigma n result XRP in, and XRP in convolved with sigma n minus 1, it will result XRP in minus 1. Okay, so these are the basic concept before going to convert the whole process in frequency domain. Now let's come back toward the sampling process. So we have to convert the whole process into frequency domain. This is XRT, it is a band limited signal. When we convert this XRT into the frequency domain, so actually it corresponds all the frequencies present in this signal, and XRT becomes this XRP omega, which represent these range of frequencies. Okay, now this is a periodic train, impulse train. When we convert this into frequency domain, it becomes this signal, and then we have in time domain, we have multiply these two signals, so this multiplication becomes convolution. Sorry, so now we have to convolve these two signal. We have to convolve this X up omega with this impulse train. So X up C omega and S up omega. X up C omega when convolved with 1 by T is, these are unit impulses, delayed version of unit impulses. So we know that when X up in, when X up in convolved with n minus 1, so it result X up n minus 1. So here the same rules applied. When X up C omega convolved with the delayed version of the impulses, then it will result this signal. Okay, so now when we plot this signal, what we will get, we have X up omega, and now we have to plot X up omega minus n omega s. So now when X up omega convolved with the impulse train, so what we will get? We will get this signal. So we see that the Fourier transform of this signal consists of periodically repeated copies of the Fourier transform of X up CT. So the copies of X up C omega are shifted by integer multiples of the sampling frequency omega s. Actually, when X up C omega convolved with this impulse train, so it will result this signal. From where this comes, we have converted X up C, the original continuous time signal, to frequency domain. We have converted the impulse train into frequency domain. In time domain, we have multiply X up CT with the impulse train, while in frequency domain, this multiplication becomes convolution. So after convolution, we have the result in the frequency domain. We have this result in the frequency domain, and this is the sampled version of the X up C omega. So now, how to reconstruct the original signal? We have to simply pass this signal through a low pass filter whose transfer function is this. So if this signal is passed through a filter whose impulse response, whose frequency transfer function is this, so actually it will pass this signal, this portion, and by taking the inverse Fourier transform, we will get this original signal x sub ct. So this is how we going from continuous into discrete domain and back to continuous domain. Now the question arises on the sampling frequency, that what should be the sampling frequency. So this issue is sought out by the Nyquist sampling theorem. According to Nyquist sampling, the sampling frequency must be at least twice of the maximum frequency in the signal. Let's suppose the signal have a maximum frequency of 3 units, so the sampling frequency must be at least 6 units. Now let's come and saw an example. Now let's suppose this is a signal whose maximum frequency is 3 hertz or 3 units. Now this, according to Nyquist, if our first must be equal to, this should be the least frequency in order to reconstruct the signal. Okay, so the sampling frequency must be twice of the maximum frequency in the signal in order to reconstruct this signal back. Okay, so the sampling frequency should be 6 unit, so it is 0 6 12 18, so it has a frequency of 6. Okay, after 6 seconds actually it repeats itself. So now when these two signals are convolved, so what we will get, this is, if let's suppose if this is convolved with this impulse, so we know that when this signal is convolved with this impulse, the result will be the same signal, but it will have a different time index because it is a delayed. So minus 3 and minus 12, it will start from minus 15. And it will end to minus 9. Now when this signal is convolved with this, so minus 3 and minus 6, it will start from minus 9. And minus 6 plus 3, it will end to minus 6, and 3 is minus 3. Similarly, this is 0, so this signal will start from minus 3, and it will end 3 plus 0. So this will be 3. Similarly, this is minus 3 plus 6, this result in 3. 3 plus 6, this result in 9, and so on. So this is the convolved version of this signal. So if we are going to keep the sampling frequency as twice of the maximum frequency, then there is no overlapping, and we can get the original signal x sub omega bypassing this signal through a low pass filter. If we pass this signal through a low pass filter whose h of omega is what? Whose h of omega is this, whose frequency transfer function is from minus 3 to 3, then if this signal is passed from through this filter, then we will get back the original signal. This is h of omega, and when this signal is passed, so we will actually get this portion back. So when the sampling frequency is twice of the maximum frequency, then there will be no aliasing, no overlapping of frequencies, and we will be theoretically able to get back this x sub omega from this signal. Now what will happen if we are going to violate this? If f of s is greater than 2 f of m, what will happen? And if f of s is less than 2 f of m, then what will happen? We have to study these two cases as well. So let's consider the same problem, but we have to change the sampling frequency. Here the sampling frequency is 6, so in this case we have to consider the sampling frequency as 8, because what is the maximum frequency is 3, so 2 into 3 is 6. So if we choose the sampling frequency to be 8 units, so 8 is greater than 6. Okay, so in this case we have to choose f of s to be 8 unit and f of m to be 3 unit. In this case we have to choose f of s to be 5, and because we have to fulfill this condition. So if f of m is 3, so 2 f of m will be 6 and 5 will be less than 6. So now let's consider the first case. If the sampling frequency is greater than 2 f of m, then what will happen? So keep in mind, here we see that if we agar hum jo sampling frequency hai usko twice of the maximum frequency, if we are going to fulfill this condition, agar hum is condition ko fulfill karte hai to phir hum theoretically hum is signal ko wapas retrieve kar sakte hai, kyunki in do signals ko convert karne se hamare paas ye signal aa gaya. और अगर इस सिग्नल को हम एक लो पास फिल्टर से पास करें, एक ऐसे लो पास फिल्टर से जो कि आइडियल उसका फ्रीक्वेंसी ट्रांसफर फंक्शन, दिस इज़ एन आइडियल फिल्टर, क्योंकि प्रैक्टिकली कभी भी आपके पास फिल्टर का जो रिस्पांस है वो इस तरह नहीं होता, फिल्टर का रिस्पांस इस तरह होता है, ठीक है. तो दिस इज़ एन आइडियल फिल्टर, तो अगर इसको हम एक आइडियल फिल्टर से पास करें, ठीक है, तो हम ये सिग्नल जो है हम इसको रिट्रीव कर सकते हैं, और इसका इन्वर्स फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म लेके हम एक साफ सी जो है वो हम दोबारा रिट्रीव कर सकते हैं. नाउ अगर हम सैम्पलिंग फ्रिक्वेंसी को बढ़ाते हैं तो फिर हमारे पास क्या होगा? यहाँ पे आप देखें, नाउ एफ आप एम जो है वो क्या है, माइनस 3 से लेकर 3 के, यानी जो सिग्नल में है उसमें मैक्सिमम फ्रिक्वेंसी क्या है, वो 3 यूनिट है. देखिए 2 इंटू 3 क्या बनेगा, 6 बनेगा, लेकिन हम 6 से ज़्यादा सैम्पलिंग फ्रिक्वेंसी रख रहे हैं. तो 6 से ज़्यादा का मतलब है कि लेट्स सपोज हमने सैम्पलिंग फ्रिक्वेंसी क्या रख दी, 8 रख दी. तो दिस इज़ 0, 8, 16, 24, -8, -16, ये उस जो यूनिट इम्पल्स ट्रेन है उसकी हमने ये फ्रिक्वेंसी हमने उसकी सेट कर दी. अब लेट सपोज देखें, अब ये -16 के साथ कन्वॉल्व होगा, ये जो सिग्नल है ये पहले इस इम्पल्स ट्रेन के साथ कन्वॉल्व होगा, तो -3 एंड -16 इट बिकम्स -19, 3 एंड -16 बिकम्स -13. सो ये सिग्नल जब इसके साथ कन्वॉल्व होगा तो रिजल्टेंट यही सिग्नल आएगा, लेकिन वो क्या होगा, वो डिलेट होगा, यानी -19 से -13 तक होगा. अब ये सिग्नल जब इस -8 वाले इम्पल्स के साथ कन्वॉल्व होगा तो क्या होगा, -3 एंड -8 -11, 3 एंड -8 -5. इसी तरह अब ये सिग्नल इसके साथ कन्वॉल्व होगा, क्योंकि देखिए हमने एक प्रॉपर्टी पढ़ी थी कि एक्स ऑफ एन व्हेन कन्वॉल्व विद सिग्मा एन प्लस सिग्मा एन माइनस वन, तो हमने क्या कहा था कि ये किसके बराबर होगा, एक्स ऑफ एन प्लस एक्स ऑफ एन माइनस वन. सो एक्चुअली दिस इज एक्स ऑफ एन एंड दिस इज एक्स ऑफ एन -16, एक्स ऑफ एन -8, एक्स ऑफ सिग्मा एन, सॉरी सिग्मा एन -16, सिग्मा एन -8, सिग्मा एन प्लस 8, ये इसी तरह ये इम्पल्स ट्रेन. तो ये हम इस तरह कर सकते हैं, ठीक है, हम पढ़ चुके हैं. तो अब देखें, यहाँ पे अगर हमने अभी यहाँ पे अगर हम इसको एक लो पास फिल्टर से गुजारें, ठीक है, अगर हम इसको एक लो पास फिल्टर से गुजारें, और वो लो पास फिल्टर बेशक आइडियल ना हो, क्योंकि इनके दरमियान इस सिग्नल को हम आसानी से वापस रिट्रीव कर सकते हैं, ठीक है. सो यहाँ पे इस सिग्नल को आइडियल फिल्टर से गुजारना लाजमी नहीं है, क्योंकि देयर इज़ अ ह्यूज ऑफ स्पेस. सो अगर हमारे पास फिल्टर का रिस्पांस ये भी हो तो उससे भी अगर हम इसको पास करें तो हमारे पास ये सिग्नल वापस आ सकता है. तो यहाँ पे दिस इज़ एक्चुअली अ प्रैक्टिकल सिस्टम. अगर हम इस कंडीशन को फुलफिल करते हैं कि सैम्पलिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी मस्ट बी इक्वल टू 2 एफ एफ एम, तो ये थ्योरेटिकल केस होगा. यहाँ पे हम रिकंस्ट्रक्शन कर सकते हैं, लेकिन वो थ्योरेटिकली, क्योंकि ये फिल्टर जो है ये थ्योरेटिकली एग्जिस्ट करता है, यानी ये फिल्टर जिसका फ्रिक्वेंसी ट्रांसफर फंक्शन आइडियल हो, ठीक है, तो ये थ्योरेटिकली एग्जिस्ट करता है। तो यहाँ पे हम थ्योरेटिकली रिकंस्ट्रक्शन कर सकते हैं, लेकिन अगर सैम्पलिंग फ्रिक्वेंसी को हम थोड़ा सा बढ़ाए तो हम क्या कर सकते हैं, प्रैक्टिकली हम रिकंस्ट्रक्शन कर सकते हैं और हमारे पास कोई अलियासिंग नहीं होगी। अब हमारे पास एक और केस है कि अगर सैम्पलिंग फ्रिक्वेंसी को हम कम रख के, टू इफ आपिम से हम कम रख के, तो हमारे पास की फिर क्या होगा, हमारे पास रिकंस्ट्रक्शन नहीं होगी और हमारे पास अलियासिंग होगी, तो भी हमने इस चीज़ को भी स्टडी करना है। अब यहाँ पे देखें, हमारे पास ये एक्स आप ओमेगा है, इसका जो मैक्सिमम फ्रिक्वेंसी रेंज है -3 से 3 है, और यहाँ पे इसकी सैम्पलिंग फ्रिक्वेंसी है जो है वो है 4 है। तो जब ये दोनों कन्वॉल्व होंगे तो -3 और -8, तो इट विल स्टार्ट फ्राम -11 एंड 3 एंड -8, सो दिस विल एंड्स टू 3 एंड -8 विल -5। तो आपके पास ये -11 से स्टार्ट होके -5 तक आ जाएगा, फिर ये इसके साथ कन्वॉल्व होगा -3 और -4, तो दूसरा सिग्नल जो है -7 से स्टार्ट होगा और वो ख़त्म होगा 3 एंड माइनस, तो -1 पे ख़त्म होगा। इस तरह ये बाकी भी आप कैलकुलेट करके देख सकते हैं। अब यहाँ पे देखें कि यहाँ से ये सिग्नल जो है लो पास फिल्टर के थ्रू वापस रिट्रीव करना इम्पॉसिबल है, ठीक है। तो ये जो पोर्शन है, ये जो ओवरलैपिंग पोर्शन है, ठीक है, ये डिस्टॉर्शन है, ठीक है, और ये अलियासिंग कहलाता है, ठीक है। यानी इस ओवरलैपिंग की वजह से, ये जो आपके पास ओवरलैपिंग आ रहा है, ठीक है, इस ओवरलैपिंग की वजह से वी आर नॉट एबल टू गेट बैक द ओरिजिनल सिग्नल, सो दैट इज़ वाई वी कीप द सैम्पलिंग फ्रिक्वेंसी एट लीस्ट ट्वाइस ऑफ द मैक्सिमम फ्रिक्वेंसी पर थ्योरेटिकल रिकंस्ट्रक्शन, एंड पर प्रैक्टिकल रिकंस्ट्रक्शन वी हैव टू कीप द सैम्पलिंग फ्रिक्वेंसी अ लिटिल बिट हाई फ्राम द ट्वाइस ऑफ द मैक्सिमम फ्रिक्वेंसी। तो आज के लेक्चर में इतना ही काफ़ी है, ठीक है, मिलेंगे इंशाल्लाह अगले लेक्चर में। ओके जी, अल्लाह हाफिज़।